good morning, guys. This is Cody with Gupta. As we know in our last video, we learned about if, else, while loops, and the fundamentals. So basically, we learned that all of these connect together, making a beautiful code for us. So now let's add more pieces to that puzzle. Now today, guys, we're gonna learn about if conditionals using the level I love the most, Maniac Munchkins. Now, I already have everything set up for us, so we just hit play. So, guys, what is conditional? What is conditional in basic English? Condition. If this happens, this happens. Or else, this happens. So, condition. It's like, when this is true, this thing happens. If this is false, this thing happens. So, it's like a director to true or false. So guys, here we have a typical example of conditionals. See, you see this here? This is our typical example. If condition 1 equals to this, a code, this only happens if condition 1 is true. Else if condition 2. This only happens if condition 1 is false and condition 2 is true. And else. It happens if both of them are false. But you can attack something using a name, like a string, as we talked about. Here is our attack song. So now, let's check our code. Now see, now we have our conditionals in action. So, while true, we create our variables enemy, hero find nearest enemy, distance, hero the distance to enemy. If enemy equals hero is ready to cleave. Cleave is a new type of task where we killed everybody in the range. So, for you to understand, let's look at this code and focus on the cleaving and the code. And now, if hero is ready to cleave, hero cleaves the enemy. Else if. Now we have our conditionals in action. So, if the first condition is false, we'll go to the second condition. If the second condition is false, we'll go to the third condition. So now, else if. If the distance to enemy is less than 5, where the enemy equals hero find nearest enemy, hero attacks the enemy. Else, hero dot attacks the chest. Now you see here, there's a chest. So now let's run it. Okay, why is this thing buffering? Hello. Okay, sorry guys, I'm just reloading the site.
Code combat.
Okay, now sorry guys, now we have the picture. Now in the picture, we see that there's a chest. And if we attack that, we get gold. But, we have enemies around. And let's see how our codes help us defeat the enemy. Now you see, when he cleaved, he killed all the enemies in his range. And now the enemies will circle him, attack him, and cleave them all out. So basically, the code is like navigating together, like navigating his way through a forest to success. Now guys, let's look at a flowchart on how this is true. The test expression. The test expression is like the basic, like what we are doing. It's like, for example, just now in code combat, we had this. This is our test expression. And if the test expression is true, he goes to the body of if. Means this is the body of if he was ready to cleave. Because if it's true, he'll execute the code and statement just below it. And then the code is done. But what if it's false? It'll go to the nested test expression. Actually guys, I got a little bit of mixed up. Test expression is like all the code over here, like in our computer, it simulates the test, like a test expression. So guys, let's keep going. Now, if it's false, it goes to the next expression. Now, it goes to else or if. If it is true, it goes to the body of nested if, statement just below it, and it executes. If it's false, it goes to the body of nested else, it goes, and it's done. So guys, now you see how all of this connects together, making a really good film. So now, let's just have a little more close combat to understand this in action. Now, let's go look for some more levels which have Elsa. Forest, fire, dancing.
Of course.
Let's see how we pass this one.
Code combat.
Now, you can use a nested if statement inside another if statement to make complex choices. Let's see how we do this. Now, this is like an if in an if, like nested. Nested together. Yeah, that's why it's called nested ifs. An if in an if. So, let's go on and check our code. While the same and true, barrel evil story for Hero Find Real Sion. Since we can't type evil item or item, since there's no item around, we can basically identify it as basic item. Hero Find Real Sion. And now, if there's an evil stone, because it's already assigned its name in the database, variable pulse equals evil stone dot position. If there's an evil stone and if the pulse.x is 34, hero moves to 46 to 42. So I think that's 34. So if it's 34, as he said in the code, he moves to 46-22, the right block. Else, hero moves to 34-22. Let's check what is 34-22. He moves to the left. Else, hero stands in the middle. Now you see how two else's go together. If an else is after an else, they'll execute. Because if else, we should write a conditional. But we don't need a conditional. Because look, variable pose equals hero stone evil stone of pose. Else, hero moves right. Else, hero moves right. So, see, they're moving as per the evil stone. So the database will give us the evil stone on Alishimu. Let's see how this code works. As you guys saw, without the evil stone, he can run away from everything easily. And now, as he runs off, he is using the evil stone to detect where he should run. Now, we run. So, thank you guys for watching this video. Please like, share, and subscribe. I hope you understand nested ifs. Please code and subscribe. This is Gautam signing off.